We will now start with the reactivity series of metals. We have learned that some metals are chemically very reactive, while others are less reactive or do not react at all. On this basis, we can understand the reactivity series of metals. On the basis of reactivity of different metals with oxygen, water and acids, as well as the displacement reactions, metals have been arranged in the decreasing order of their reactivities. This arrangement of metals in the order of decreasing reactivities is called reactivity series or activity series of metals. So we can define reactivity series as the arrangement of metals in order of decreasing reactivities is the reactivity series or activity series of metals. We will now learn the reasons for different reactivities of different metals. In the activity series of metals, the basis for reactivity is the tendency of metals to lose electrons. If a metal can lose electrons easily to form positive ions, it will readily react with other substances and it will be a reactive metal. So, a reactive metal is the one which loses electrons readily. On the other hand, if a metal loses electrons less rapidly to form a positive ion, it will react slowly with the other substances and such a metal will be less reactive. Thus, a less reactive metal is the one which loses electrons less readily. For example, alkali metals like lithium, sodium, potassium lose electrons very rapidly to form alkali metal ions and therefore these metals are reactive. We will now take a look at the activity series of some common metals, starting with lithium, potassium, barium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, nickel, tin, lead, hydrogen, copper, mercury, silver, gold and platinum. Symbol for lithium is Li, potassium K, barium Ba, Na for sodium, Ca for calcium, Mg for magnesium, aluminium is Al, Zn for zinc, Fe for iron, Ni for nickel, Sn for tin, Pb for lead, H for hydrogen, Cu for copper, Hg for mercury, Ag for silver, Au for gold, and Pt for platinum. In this table, the most reactive metal is the metal which is placed at the top of the series, that is lithium, while the least reactive metal is the one which is placed at the bottom of the table, that is platinum. As we go down in this table, the chemical reactivity of metal decreases. So this metal, table shows that lithium is the most reactive metal, potassium is less reactive, and as we move down the table, the reactivity of metals decreases. Platinum is the least reactive metal. The metals which are above hydrogen in the reactivity series, are metals more reactive than hydrogen. While the metals which are below hydrogen in the reactivity series are less reactive than hydrogen. We can understand the reasons for different reactivities of different metals. That is, if we say lithium is placed above potassium, lithium loses electrons more rapidly as compared to potassium. Potassium loses electrons more rapidly as compared to barium. So the reason for different reactivities of different metals in the series is the tendency of metals to lose electrons. Also, we can understand the displacement of hydrogen from acids by metals. The more active metals than hydrogen, for example lithium, potassium, barium, sodium, calcium, etc., can liberate hydrogen from acids like HCl and H2SO4. These metals have a greater tendency to lose electrons than hydrogen, and therefore the H plus ions in the acids will accept electrons and give hydrogen gas as per the following equations. If we consider metal M to be more reactive than hydrogen, which could be any metal among the different metals which are being placed above hydrogen in the reactivity series, this metal M loses electron, becomes positive ion. H plus ion from the acid, maybe HCl or H2SO4, accepts this electron and converts into hydrogen atom. But because one single hydrogen atom is not stable, two atoms will combine to form molecule of hydrogen, that is hydrogen gas. The metals which are below hydrogen in the reactivity series, like copper, mercury, silver, gold and platinum, cannot liberate hydrogen from acids like HCl and H2SO4 because these metals have lesser tendency to lose electrons than hydrogen, and therefore they cannot lose electrons to H plus ion. The reactivity series also explains displacement reactions. In general, a more reactive metal, for example, sodium is more reactive than zinc, can displace less reactive metal from its salt solution. So, for example, if we have a salt solution of zinc, like ZnSO4, and we introduce sodium metal in it, sodium being placed above zinc can displace zinc from its salt solution to form its salt, and zinc metal will be liberated.